News is brought to you by the Y Factor Salon in Butler. Rainy and a bit miserable this weekend. Your forecast is coming up. A Nebraska man found himself with a complimentary one-night stay at the Bates County Jail after a traffic stop. 27-year-old Ryan Fields of Omaha was charged with driving while intoxicated, along with a side dish of careless and imprudent. He was held for 12-hour detox and later released with a pending court date in Bates County. Archie police are still searching for those responsible for throwing Molotov cocktails at the Archie Sports Complex. The remnants of bottles stuffed with rags and gasoline were found following a report of a fire at the complex on Christmas Day. Police are looking for a dark-colored Dodge Dart. If you have any info, please contact the Archie Police Department. On a positive note, a young man from Archie who was struck by a vehicle while riding his bike back in September got a very special Christmas this year. While it was a complete accident, the boy was left without a bicycle, and a group of local businesses and individuals made a donation to make sure he got a new bike, along with a few other Christmas gifts as well. The boy is doing fine, and a big thank you goes to all those who helped with the cause. This week, the Adrian Optimus Club made a donation to the Adrian School Backpack Program. The $500 gift will help provide meals for children to take home on the weekends. The Optimist also gave $1,500 to the Christmas Fund, which provided presents for local families in need. According to State Representative Patricia Pike, the state of Missouri is planning to invest some $1.5 billion to retain some 4,000 jobs at a General Motors facility in Wentzville, Missouri. According to Governor Mike Parson, the plan was put into effect to keep good-paying jobs in Missouri, and not only will benefit those in the Wentzville area, but statewide as well, due to the fact that the GM facility generates about $2 billion annually. More news and weather on the way. It's one stop for the entire family at the Y Factor Salon in Butler. Hair and nails for the ladies and a full-time barber for the guys. You'll get a great cut for about the same price. The Y Factor's next to Corner Hardware on Ohio Street in Butler. In obituary news, John Chatham, 70, of Butler, passed away on December 24th. There will be no public services. Arrangements are under the direction of Schoengert Funeral Chapel, and condolences may be left online at schoengertchapel.com. Helen McClure, 66, of Deepwater, passed away December 22nd in Bolivar, Missouri. Services will be this Monday at 7 p.m., with visitation beginning at 6 p.m. at Vansant Mills Funeral Home in Clinton, Missouri. Weather, warm today, but expect showers to be ongoing all afternoon, high around 60. Winds will pick up this evening, and tomorrow a pretty dramatic change with lingering showers, high around 45, and maybe even more windy than today. We'll drop to a high around 39 on Monday and slowly trickle up from there. Tuesday will be sunny and 45, and then look for highs to hang in the 50s for the rest of the week. That's news for now, brought to you by the Y Factor Salon in Butler. Have a great weekend.